my dear friends, in this video we are going to know about the hair. So what is a hair? Anatomy of the hair, biological, physical and chemical facts about the hair, types of hair. Coming to the hair growth, myths as well as the facts. Coming to the first, what is a hair? Hair is a protein filament that grows from a follicle found in the dermis or in the skin. It is one of the defining characteristics of mammals, an important biomaterial primarily composed of protein, notably keratin. So the keratin is the main ingredient present in the hair as well as the nails. So coming to the anatomy of the hair, the very inner, we have the hyaline layer. This is the cortex of the hair. So medullary means always it will be the center. And we have the Henle layer. So we have many layers like this. And next, hair is composed of three principal parts. One is cuticle, the outer coating composed of overlapping scales. Cortex, protein-rich structure. So around the medulla, which contains a pigment. So medulla is the central core, may be present or absent. The structure of hair has been compared to that of a pencil, with the medulla being the lead, the cortex being the wood, and the cuticle is nothing but the paint on the outside. Coming to the cuticle varies in its scales, how many there are per centimeter, how much they overlap, their overall shape, and how much they protrude from the surface, its thickness, and whether or not it contains the pigment. Characteristics of the cuticle may be the important in distinguishing between the hairs of different species, but are often not useful in distinguishing between different people. So this is the picture of the cuticle. We can able to see this. These are like scales. So this is the cuticle of the hair. If we see under the microscope, so this is the picture of the hair. Next, cortex. The cortex varies in thickness, texture, and color. Distribution of cortex is perhaps the most important component in determining from which an individual human hair may come from. So microscopic examination can also reveal the condition and shape of the root and tip. So here we have the cortex. So this is the picture of cortex. Medulla, the anatomy of the hair. The medulla may vary in thickness, continuity. One is continuous structure or broken into pieces. In this picture we can see, here we have the broken pieces. In this picture we have the continuous structure. So one continuous structure or broken into pieces. Opacity, how much of light is able to pass through it. It may be absent in some species. Like the cuticle, the medulla can be important for distinguishing between the hairs of different species, but often does not tend to be much important information to differentiation between the hairs of different people. So biological, physical and chemical facts about the hair. Coming to the facts about the hair, hair is composed of a protein called keratin, which is also the primary component of finger and toenails. So human develops the hair follicles during the fetal development and no new follicles are produced after birth. So hair color is mostly the result of pigments, which are chemical compounds that reflects the certain wavelengths of visible light. So hair shape, round or oval, and texture, curly or straight, is influenced heavily by the genes. The physical appearance of hair can be affected by nutritional status and an intentional alteration, heat curling, perms straightening, etc. The body area, head, arm, leg, back, etc., from which a hair is originated, can be determined by the sample's length, shape, size, color and other physical characteristics. In order to test hair evidence for a nuclear DNA, the root must be present. So the hair may also be tested under the mitochondrial DNA, whether or not the root is present. The cuticle of human hair is rough, which is why we use as a conditioner. Because of that only we use the conditioner, because the cuticles are very rough. Animals have characteristic cuticle scales that scientists have been used to determine the source of hair evidence. Human, cat, dog, mouse, etc. Representatively, this is the pictures of the different cuticles. So coming to the types of hair. So we have Lanuga hair, develops on an unborn baby. 3 months after the baby's conception, fine and soft, grows all over the body at the same rate shed about the 4 weeks before the baby due to be born. Next, vellus hair, which is short, fine, downy, unpigmented hair covering most of the body except the palms and the soles of the feet. Women normally retain 55% of more vellus hair than men. Follicle doesn't have oily glands. Long, thick, pigmented hair. So we have one more hair, which we call it as terminal hair. Long, thick, pigmented hair found on the scalp, legs, arms, bodies of males and females. Coarser than the vellus hair, and which is an exception of grey hair, it is pigmented. Produced by the follicles with sebaceous glands. So these are the types of different types of animal hairs. This is the cat, horse, we have the pig, rat, dog, humans, rabbit. So we have the different, there is a difference in the different types of animal hairs as well as with the humans. Coming to the hair growth myths and coming facts. So gray hair is a coarser and more resistant than the pigment hair. Fact. Other than the lack of the pigment, grey hair is exactly the same as the pigmented hair. It is not resistant because it is grey, and it is not more resistant than the pigmented hair on the same person's head. Amount of natural color is determined by racial background. Fact, anyone of any race can have a straight or extremely curled hair. That is the fact. Next, clipping, shaving, trimming and cutting makes the hair grow faster. Fact is, there is no effect on hair growth of cutting, shaving, trimming or scalp massage increases the hair growth. There is no evidence to indicate that it is true. So minoxidil and finasteride are the only treatments that have been proven to increase the hair growth and are approved for these purposes for FDA, means Food and Drug Administrations. Hair with round and cross section is straight. Hair with oval cross section is wavy. Hair with flats cross section is curly. The fact is, cross-section of straight hair tend to be round and curlier. Hair tend to be more oval, but cross-section of hair can be almost any shape, including triangular. The shape of cross-section does not always relate to the amount of curl or the shape of the follicle. So, thank you very much. Please do like, share, comment and subscribe to my channel.